On the other hand, innal muttaqina, indeed those people who have taqwa. Where will they be? Fi jannatin, in gardens, wa na'imin, and in pleasure. The muttaqin, who is a muttaqi? The one who protects himself, safeguards himself from what? The punishment of Allah, the anger of Allah. How? By doing what Allah has commanded and staying away from what Allah has forbidden. So for instance, when a person prays salah, is he a muttaqi? Yes. When a person is praying salah properly, is he a muttaqi? Yes. Similarly, when a person is staying away from lying, is he a muttaqi? Yes. So إِنَّ الْمُتَّقِينَ, those who live by the command that Allah has given, saving themselves from the anger of Allah, the punishment of Allah, they will be fi jannatin wa na'im, in gardens and in pleasure. Jannat. Notice the tanween. Tanween is for ta'zeem. And na'imin, meaning na'im, happiness, delight, comfort. Every type of comfort will be in Jannah. Whether it is the comfort, the happiness, the bliss that a person experiences in his body or in his qalb. Every type of na'im. And this is in contrast to the torment of the punishment for those people who deny. Fakihina, enjoying. Fakihina, plural of fakih. Who is fakih? One who enjoys. One who has fun. One who is very happy. And he also makes other people happy. How? That when a person is very happy on the inside, he's enjoying. He will smile. He will joke. He will say good things. And when he will say good things, what will happen? What will happen? People around him will also become happy. So faqih is someone who is enjoying. Someone who is very cheerful. Someone who is merry. He's happy, he's also making others happy. So faqihina, the people of Jannah, rejoicing, delighting, enjoying. Why? Bima atahum rabbuhum, with what their Lord has given to them. They'll be enjoying, very happy, because of everything that Allah has given to them, because of the various blessings that Allah has bestowed them with in Jannah. In Surah Al-Dhariyat, Ayah 16, earlier we learned, أَخِذِينَ مَا آتَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ. Here, فَاكِهِينَ بِمَا آتَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ وَوَقَاهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ عَذَابَ الْجَحِيمِ. And their Lord has saved them from the punishment of the blazing fire. And this itself is a joy. Being saved from the punishment. Being protected from the punishment. This itself is a joy. This itself is a means of pleasure, excitement, thrill for a person. And it will be said to them, kulu, eat, washrabu, and drink, hani'an, in satisfaction. Why? Bima kuntum ta'malun, for what you used to do. Why will this be said to them? To honor them. That eat and drink in satisfaction. Eat of what? Of every bliss in Jannah. Every enjoyable food that is available in Jannah. Anything that you want, anything that you desire. Washrabu, and drink. Drink of the rivers, the springs, the lovely drinks that are in Jannah. And how should you eat and drink? Hani'an. Hani'an, from the root letters, ha, noon, hamza, hana. Hana is that which is gained without any difficulty. Meaning that which you gain, that which you get, and you don't have any difficulty in getting it. And it's also such that once you get it, once you enjoy it, it's also very satisfying. It's also very pleasing. In other words, it doesn't have any harmful effects either. You know, sometimes to prepare some food, you have to put in so much effort. So much effort. You spend 2 hours and you eat in 15 minutes. This is not hani, because it doesn't satisfy you as well. Because you spend so much time and at the end you only get 15-20 minutes of enjoyment. It doesn't seem fair. Hani is that which you get easily and that which really satisfies you to the full. Similarly, sometimes it happens that you enjoy some particular food. You eat it, you find it very delicious, but you overeat. And then you suffer from the consequences later. Or what happens? You think that something is good for you. You have it, even a little bit. But what happens? That one bite was enough to give you a stomach upset later. This is not hani. When you have this fear that this food I'm eating, this drink I'm drinking, it's going to give me bad after effects. Can you eat and drink in satisfaction? Not at all. You eat and drink with fear. Isn't it so? Like for example, if someone has a dairy allergy, they love ice cream. On Eid, they say, okay, today I'm going to have ice cream. Now their tongue, they're enjoying a lot over there. But at the same time, they have this worry on their head. I'm going to suffer the consequences later. This is not honey. But we see in Jannah, kulu washrabu hani'an. Eat and drink in full enjoyment. Fully satisfying yourselves. Satisfying yourselves. That you will not suffer from any bad effects afterwards. It's easy to get the food. You make a request. Before even you make a request, the food comes to you. Whatever you desire, whatever you wish. And then on top of that, no matter how much you eat, no matter what you eat, it's not going to have any bad effects. Why? Bima kuntum ta'malun. Because of what you used to do. See how important amal is? What an important role amal plays? Earlier, with regards to the people of hellfire, what was said? إِنَّمَا تُجْزَوْنَ مَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. And over here, كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا هَنِيئًا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Because of what you used to do. Actions, deeds are very important. مُتَّكِئِينَ عَلَى سُرُرٍ. They will be reclining on couches, on thrones. What kind of couches? مَصْفُوفَ. Ones that are lined up in rows. مُتَّكِئِين, plural of muttaki. And who is muttaki? One who is reclining against something, taking support from something, resting against something. And when a person is sitting like this, what does it show? He's very comfortable, relaxed, happy, no worries, no tension, no anxiety, nothing. Muttaki'een, the people of Jannah, reclining. Ala sururin. Surur is a plural of sarid, and sarid is a bed or an elevated couch. The Arabs, what kind of sitting arrangements do they have, even till today? Floor, isn't it? But sarir is that which is elevated, so like a couch or a bed. And it's basically, if you look at the root, sin rara, from the same root as the word surur, pleasure. Why? Because when a person sits on it, then he finds pleasure. And only those who are in surur can actually sit on it comfortably. So muttaki'ina ala sururin. They will be reclining on thrones, on couches that are masfufa. Masfufa from saf. Arranged in rows, lined up. Lined up. Why? Because it shows they'll be sitting next to one another. Like for example, you are sitting in rows. You are sitting next to one another. If a person is sitting on a lovely, comfortable couch all by himself with all the food and drink available to him, can he have a good time? No. You only have a good time when you have somebody to talk to, somebody to eat with, someone to drink with, someone to sit with. So masfufa, wazawwajnahum, and we wedded them, we will marry them, meaning the people of Jannah, they will be with who? Bihurin een, with hurin een, women with large beautiful eyes. This is a description of the women of Jannah. Hur is a plural of hawra, and hawra is someone who is very fair. Very fair. And Ayn is a plural of Ayna. And Ayna is someone with very big, beautiful, wide eyes. Attractively wide-eyed. So these are the women of Jannah. Beautiful women. Wide and beautiful eyes. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And those who believed. وَاتَّبَعَتْهُمْ ذُرِّيَّتُهُمْ بِإِيمَانٍ. And their descendants also followed them in faith. Those people who believed. And it wasn't just that they believed and did good themselves. No. But وَاتَّبَعَتْهُمْ. It followed them. Who followed them? ذُرِّيَّتُهُمْ. Their children. So their children also followed their footsteps. The footsteps of who? Their believing parents. Their believing ancestors. How did they follow them? بِإِيمَانٍ. In iman. Not that because their father was a doctor, they also became a doctor. Not that because their family had a particular business, so they also continued in that business. No, this is not what's being mentioned. They followed their parents, their ancestors, in what? In iman. That just as their parents were righteous, even they were righteous. Just as their parents were believing, even they were believing. So the parents were believers and their children also were believers. So such families, now imagine, many people have iman, but every person's iman is not of the same level, isn't it? Similarly, all believers perform righteous deeds, but every believer's righteous deeds are not at the same level. Isn't it? Now, parents and children, basically families, they're believers. Everyone is of a different level. Therefore, technically, they should be in different levels. Isn't it so? And the difference in the levels of Jannah, how is it? Like you see the stars. Now just imagine, one child is here and the parents are up there. Okay, they are in Jannah, but still they're not with you. They're not with you. So look at the mercy of Allah. Such people, أَلْحَقْنَا بِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتُهُمْ, we will join with them their children. أَلْحَقْنَا لَمْ حَاقَافْ. What does that mean? Ilhaq is when something meets up with the one that is before it. Like for example, one person goes, the other person goes after him. Now the one who goes after him, when he meets up with the other, joins the other, this is ilhaq. وَيَسْتَبْشِرُونَ بِالَّذِينَ لَمْ يَلْحَقُوا بِهِمْ. So أَلْحَقْنَا بِهِمْ. In Jannah, in paradise, we will join their children with them. So that both are at the same level. So that the families are also united in Jannah. You understand? They are at the same level. Even though their actions, their levels may have varied, but out of the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will join them together in the same level. أَلْحَقْنَا بِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ. But does this mean that the parents will be brought lower? Or that the children will be brought lower just so that they can be united? No. In Jannah, you only get upgraded. You never get downgraded. You understand? You only get upgraded. You don't get downgraded. So Allah says, وَمَا أَلَتْنَاهُمْ, and we will not decrease them. مِنْ عَمَلِهِمْ, of their deeds. مِنْ شَيْءٍ, anything at all. Meaning the deeds of the parents, they will not be reduced. They will not be rewarded less for them. So that they are brought down to the level of their children. You understand? Or for example, if it's the other way around, that the children did more, so their level is higher. Now for them to be united with their parents, it will not be done such that the deeds of the children are reduced, meaning they are rewarded less, therefore they are brought down a level. No. People will only be upgraded in Jannah. Alatna, from the root letters, Lam Ya Ta. Or Hamza Lam Ta. La yalitkum. So, وَمَا أَلَتْنَاهُمْ مِنْ عَمَلِهِمْ. What does that mean? To reduce the haq of someone or something. Reduce and then give. Or delay and then give. So the reward of their deeds will never be diminished. Will never be reduced. مِنْ شَيْءٍ, anything at all. Now, this is with regards to both children being upgraded and parents being upgraded as well. Because it's quite possible that children are more righteous or the parents are more righteous. We learned that the Prophet ﷺ said, verily Allah shall elevate the grade of a righteous servant in paradise. A person will enter Jannah and Allah will elevate his rank. So he will ask Allah, O Lord, how did I earn this? How did I get this? Meaning, technically I'm supposed to be down here, but you brought me up here. So Allah will reply, through your sons invoking me to forgive you. Your child used to pray to me to forgive you. And this is why your level has been elevated. The parent himself didn't do much. His level was of a particular. His level was somewhere low. But because the children used to pray, the son used to pray, this is why the level will be elevated. Similarly, we learn the famous hadith, when the son of Adam dies, his record of deeds will cease except in three cases: an ongoing charity, knowledge that people are benefiting from, and a righteous son who invokes Allah for him. Allah says, كُلُّ مْرِئِن, every person, every single person, imri'in, person, whether believer, non-believer, bima kasaba, for what it has earned, rahinun, held in pledge. Rahin, from the root letters, Rahanun, Rahn. And what does Rahan mean? Farihanun maqbuda, security deposit. Remember that when a person is taking a loan, to guarantee the return, what does he do? He deposits something as a security. You understand? You don't get it. Like for example, I ask you, can I please borrow your book? You say, I need it. You say, I'll return it to you. You say, okay, give me your pen then. Give me your iPad then. So you keep my iPad until I return your book. When I return it, then you give me the iPad. So the iPad becomes what? The pen becomes what? Rahan. Security deposit. This is a guarantee that the book is coming back to you. If the book is not coming back to you, the iPad is yours to keep. So, كُلُّ مْرِئِمْ بِمَا كَسَبَ رَهِينٌ. Raheen is who? Raheen fa'il. And remember, fa'il gives a meaning of fa'il, and it also gives a meaning of maf'ul. Over here, raheen gives a meaning of marhoon, maf'ul, meaning mahboos, asir, one who is retained, one who is imprisoned, one who is not allowed to go. What does it mean by this? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us for His worship. And the person who worships Him, the person who fulfills the purpose of his life, he will free himself. Every person is as though in a jail. Every person is as though kept as a security deposit. When he performs certain deeds in obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he is released. And then he is rewarded. And if a person does not fulfill the purpose of his creation, if a person does not perform certain actions, then can he release his soul? Can he? He cannot. If a person does not return the loan, can he take his rahan back? He cannot. Similarly, every single person's soul, what is it? It's as though in jail. Every person. When a person has iman, then he's qualified to go out. When a person does good deeds, then he's qualified to go out. But if he does not have iman, if he does not perform deeds, then he is going to stay in that jail forever. He cannot enjoy anything. كُلُّ مْرِئٍ بِمَا كَسَبَ رَهِينٌ. Every single person, for what he has earned, is held in pledge. He is subject to what he has done. This is just as we have learned earlier in Surah Al-Isra, that وَكُلَّ إِنسَانٍ أَلْزَمْنَاهُ طَائِرَهُ فِي عُنُقِهِ وَنُخْرِجُ لَهُ يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ كِتَابًا يَلْقَاهُ مَنْشُورًا. So every person is bound to his fate. Meaning when he does certain deeds, that's what he gets. So every person is locked up. He's like a prisoner. When he has iman, does amal salih, then he is released. If he doesn't do that, then he will be retained forever in punishment. كُلُّ مْرِئٍ بِمَا كَسَبَ رَهِينٌ. It's also said that rahinun over here means punished. So every person, for what he has acquired, he will be punished. Meaning if a person has done something wrong, he will be held accountable for it. Because in the first part of the ayah, what has been said? That people will be upgraded in Jannah. Now people will be upgraded. And the wrong that a person has done, he will be held accountable for that as well. Firstly, a person will be held accountable for the wrong that he has done. Only then when he enters Jannah, then he will be upgraded. Because a person should not misunderstand this ayah, thinking, my parents are very righteous, I don't need to do anything. If my parents are up high when I enter Jannah, which I will anyway because I'm a Muslim, this is what a person thinks, I'll be upgraded automatically, so don't need to do anything. You get it? So people might misunderstand. Allah says, no. كُلُّ مْرِئٍ بِمَا كَسَبَ رَهِينٌ. Yes, Allah's mercy is there. He will upgrade people in Jannah. However, if a person has done something wrong, he will also be held accountable for it. وَأَمْدَدْنَاهُمْ. And we will provide them. Who? The people of Jannah. أَمْدَدْنَا. مِيم دَال دَال. مَدَّ. مَدَّ is to stretch, to lengthen something. And from this it is also to replenish, to reinforce. Like for example, you have some resources. As they're running out, you replenish, you reinforce. So that it never comes to an end. It's never exhausted. So وَأَمْدَدْنَاهُمْ. And we will provide them, we will continue to provide them so that they never run out. بِفَاكِهَةٍ. With fruit. وَلَحْمٍ. And meat. مِمَّا يَشْتَهُونَ. Of that which they desire. Whatever fruit, whatever meat that a person desires, its resources will never be depleted in Jannah. You get it? You love grapefruit, for example. Few people do. But let's say a person loves grapefruit. They go to the grocery store, they buy it, they bring it home. After a few days, what's going to happen? You're going to run out of it, isn't it? You have to run again and get it. What if you don't find good ones? Too bad. You love peaches. The season is over now. You go to the grocery store, you don't find them anywhere. But we see that in Jannah, وَأَمْدَدَنَاهُمْ constantly we will replenish. Constantly we will reinforce so that they never ever run out of what? The fruit that they like, the meat that they like. فَاكِهَا وَلَحْمُ مِمَّا يَشْتَهُونَ that which they desire. مِمَّا يَشْتَهُونَ whatever they desire. So whatever food they have, it will never be stale and they will never run out of it. It will always be available for them. In Surah Al-Waqi'ah, Ayah 32-33, we learn, وَفَاكِهَةٍ كَثِيرَةٍ لَا مَقْطُوعَةٍ وَلَا مَمْنُوعَةٍ neither limited nor forbidden. The number of the fruit of the lahm that a person wants to enjoy, it's not limited in Jannah, nor is it forbidden. Everything is available to them. مَا يَشْتَهُونَ and مَا يَشْتَهُونَ even if they don't request it openly, it will be brought to them. For example, it is said that lahm, and in particular, lahmi tayr, the flesh of birds, that a person would see, for example, a bird and he will wish, I wonder what it tastes like. And before even he can make a request, it will be available right before him, prepared before him. مَا يَشْتَهُونَ يَتَنَازَعُونَ فِيهَا they will exchange with one another in Jannah. يَتَنَازَعُونَ تَنَازُعْ نُون زَيْعَيْن نَزَعْ what does نَزَعْ mean? To pull. And تَنَازُعْ is to pull from one another. You understand? To pull from one another. And it also is to exchange with one another. When something is passed around amongst people. Like for example, if I give you a bowl of dates and one person takes it, then you give it behind and they take it and they pass it around. You understand? So it's being passed around. And sometimes people pass around, like for example, a bowl of fruit in a very formal way. You get it? In a very formal way. And sometimes they pass it around in a very informal way. Like for example, you're sitting with your brother on the couch having a packet of chips. You're having it. When he wants it, is he going to ask you for it? He's going to take it from your hand. And when you want it, you're going to just take it from his hand. This is what tanazur is. What does it show? Relaxed. Right? Having fun. Enjoying. So the people of Jannah, يَتَنَازَعُونَ فِيهَا they will exchange with one another or they will take from one another. They will pull from one another because they'll be so frank, they'll be so friendly, so relaxed. What will they exchange? كَأْسًا a cup. كَأْس is used for a cup that is full of drink. And in particular, wine. So this drink, which will be in a cup, a special type of drink, they will exchange with one another. They will pull from one another. Hey, let me have a sip. No, let me take it. But Allah says, لَا لَغْوٌ فِيهَا there will be no love in it. Meaning once they will drink from that kas, it's not that they will start talking useless words. Because when a person gets drunk, how does he speak? لَغْو وَلَا تَأْثِيمٌ nor any sin. When a person gets drunk, does he end up committing sin? Yes, many sins, many wrong things. But this kas of Jannah, which is full of the wine of Jannah, when the people of Jannah will have it, they will not get intoxicated by it. It will not have any harmful effects. Like we learned earlier, hani'an. No harmful effects. So they will not speak love, nor will they do anything wrong. This shows to us that the wine of this world, it has two harmful effects. What are they? Lagh in qawl and ta'theem in action. But the wine of Jannah is free of these bad things, of these bad effects. And we see over here such a beautiful scene that the people of Jannah reclining on their couches, facing each other, talking, eating, passing around a cup of wine, so relaxed, so friendly with each other, no ill feelings, pulling from one another, so friendly. And as they drink, they don't get intoxicated. They don't say anything wrong either. Because sometimes what happens, in a relaxed atmosphere, one person might say something that's very offensive to the other. He says, give me this. And the other person says, why don't you ask me politely? No, nothing like this. No love and no ta'theem. Relaxed atmosphere, enjoying to their maximum. وَيَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ and there will circulate among them. غِلْمَانٌ لَهُمْ servant boys, especially for them. يَطُوفُ طَوَافَ to go around. So he will go around on them in order to serve them. Who? غِلْمَانٌ لَهُمْ غِلْمَان is a plural of غُلَام. Ghulam is who? A young boy, a youth. So over here, ghilman, it refers to servant boys who will be young in their age. Why young servant boys? Why do you think so? They're more quick, they're more energetic, they're quick in serving you. And these ghilman, Allah says, lahum, for them. Meaning, these ghilman will be specified to serve them. You go to a restaurant, there's one waiter serving 10 people. You have to wait in order to call him. Isn't it so? Similarly, you're having a family dinner, you go back home, you're having a family dinner, and let's say there are 8 people, and there are 2 servants. Now those 2 servants, who are they serving? 8 people. You want something, can you ask? No, you feel shy, because other people have to ask first. Their wishes need to be fulfilled first. But we see here, these servant boys, يَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ, constantly going around, so that as soon as you have a wish, you can say. And غِلْمَانُ لَهُمْ. And these غِلْمَان, how are they? Allah says, كَأَنَّهُمْ, as if they, لُؤْلُؤٌ, are pearls that are مَكْنُون, that are hidden, that are protected. مَكْنُون, كَافْ, نُون, نُون. One that is in a cover. One that is sheltered. Like pearls that are still in their covers. When they're still in their covers, what does it mean? There are no fingerprints. There are no specks of dust either. You understand? Completely clean. Fresh. So, lu'lu'um maknoon. No scratches. Untouched by hands. No dust. Not dirty at all. But rather perfectly clean. So what does this describe? The beauty of those ghilman. Now imagine if the ghilman, if the servants are like this. How about those who are being served? If the servants are like this, then how about those who are being served? How beautiful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make them. وَيَطُوفُ عَلَيْهِمْ غِلْمَانٌ لَهُمْ كَأَنَّهُمْ لُؤْلُؤٌ مَكْنُونَ, as if they are لُؤْلُؤٌ مَكْنُونَ. We listen to the recitation. Because they used to accept whatever commands Allah gave them in dunya. Over here we see that Allah will appoint servants for the people of Jannah so that every wish of theirs, every need of theirs is met with. When will that happen? When a person responds to the call of Allah as well. When a person responds to Allah's call, when he runs to Allah, فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ, then Allah out of His mercy will also appoint someone to respond to His call. That He will just make a call and instantly somebody will respond. He will make a request and instantly it will be fulfilled. So this is the reward of فَفِرُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ. And if a person does not run, if a person does not respond, then how does he expect to be responded to? Because we learn about the people of hellfire, they will scream, they will cry out for help, but no one will respond to them. فَلَا صَرِيخَ لَهُمْ. No one will hear their screams and respond. No one will care. Because when a person doesn't care about the call of Allah, then no one will care about his request. And if a person is concerned about, careful about the call of Allah, then everyone will be concerned about his requests. We listen to the recitation.
إن المتقين في جنات ونعيم فاكهين بما آتاهم ربهم ووقاهم ربهم عذاب الجحيم إن المتقين في جنات ونعيم فاكهين بما آتاهم ربهم ووقاهم ربهم عذاب الجحيم كلوا واشربوا هنيئا بما كنتم تعملون متكئين على سرر مصفوفة وزوجناهم بحور عين والذين آمنوا واتبعتهم ذريتهم بإيمان ألحقنا بهم ذريتهم وما ألتناهم من عملهم من شيء كل امرئ بما كسب رهين وأمددناهم بفاكهة ولحم مما يشتهون يتنازعون فيها كأسا لا لغو فيها ولا تأثيم ويطوف